What's happening, everybody? Landon with LMR.com. In this video, I'm gonna be taking a quick look at this billet steel flywheel from SVE, as well as showing you how to install one into your 5.0 or 5.8 liter Mustang. SVE's flywheel is constructed from very strong and lightweight billet steel. This allows the flywheel to tip the scale at roughly 17.5 pounds, whereas a factory cast iron flywheel will be upwards of 22 pounds. It features a 157 tooth count and includes bolt-on weights for different engine balances. Speaking of those engine balances, this SVE flywheel can be used with a neutral or 0 ounce imbalance engine, a 28 ounce imbalance engine, and even an engine that has a 50 ounce imbalance. This billet steel flywheel is even SFI 1.1 certified and meets their strict standards in performance and safety for aftermarket flywheels. When you open the box, you'll see one billet steel flywheel, a small weight for 28 ounce balanced engines, a larger weight for 50 ounce imbalance engines, two weight plate retaining bolts, and three dowel pins for 10.5 inch clutch applications. As far as fitment goes for this flywheel, it will work with all 1982 to 1995 push rod 5.0 or 5.8 liter engines with either a 10 or a 10.5 inch clutch. For this video, we're going to show you just how the flywheel installs. So be sure and reference our other videos for proper removal and installation of your T5 transmission, pilot bearing, and of course, if you're installing a new clutch. All of those videos are available in the description. Flywheels are always a breeze to install. The challenging part is getting to the flywheel, in that you have to obviously remove your transmission to do so. Now, a few technical notes to take away from this install. If you own a 1982 to 1985 car and you're sticking with the 10-inch clutch, it is important to use the correct pressure plate to flywheel retaining hardware. The 10-inch clutches did not utilize dowel pins to center the pressure plate to the flywheel. Instead, a shoulder on the retaining bolt was used to center the pressure plate to the flywheel, whereas the 10.5-inch clutches did utilize the dowel pins to center the pressure plate to the flywheel. 10.5-inch clutches was standard issue equipment on 1986 to 1995 V8 cars. Last but not least, since you're going through all of this work, always consider new hardware, such as flywheel retaining bolts, pilot bearing, engine block dowel pins, and of course, all the other miscellaneous hardware that pertain to the T5 transmission. With the transmission, pressure plate, clutch disc, flywheel and spacer plate removed, place the new SVE flywheel on a workbench. Ensure you know what balance you need for your engine application. If your engine has a neutral or 0 ounce imbalance, skip these next few steps. On the recessed side of the flywheel, position the correct plate over the bolt holes. Apply thread locker to the two provided countersunk bolts. Thread them in by hand and torque each bolt to 221 inch pounds. Flip the flywheel over. If you are going to be running a 10.5-inch clutch, install the three provided dowel pins into the holes that do not have threads. Use an appropriate driver to fully seat the dowels. We chose a 1/4-inch drive, 1/4-inch deep socket. Align the large side of the dowel with the non-threaded hole in the flywheel. Tap each dowel into place. Inspect the engine block dowels that center the bell housing. If they don't need to be replaced, apply some anti-seize. Inspect the bell housing spacer plate. If it's warped or any of the bolt holes are oddly shaped, replace it. Position the spacer plate over the dowels in the engine block. Apply blue thread locking compound to the flywheel to crankshaft retaining bolts. Align the flywheel bolts with the crankshaft. No worries on getting this wrong, as the holes are asymmetric and the flywheel will only go on one way. Ensure that the recessed groove is facing towards the engine. Install all of the bolts and then snug them down. If you're running a 10-inch clutch, install two of the pressure plate bolts into the correct holes for leverage. Torque each bolt in a crisscross pattern to 75 to 85 pound-feet. Use a pry bar in between the dowel pins or bolts for leverage. Of course, be sure and remove the bolts once you're finished torquing the flywheel retaining bolts. At this point, the flywheel is successfully installed. To see how the rest of the components go back together, check out part 4 of our AOD to T5 transmission swap series, or our dedicated video on installing a clutch into your Mustang. To see more how-to and review videos covering industry-leading products, be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel, like this video, and don't forget to turn on notifications. While you're at it, be sure and check out our other videos, and don't forget to shop LMR.com for all things 1979 to present Mustang and SVT life.